Yeah, no, we don't sell actual apples here, sir. That's, yeah, that's okay. All right. Hey, how's it going? Welcome to Apple. How are you? Good. I'm here to help. My name is Maddie. What's your name? Good to meet you. Definitely. Definitely. How can I help you? Oh, you have an appointment? Okay, let me look up. What was your first name? Okay. And last name? Okay, it's cool. So, yeah, just so you know, it really helps us out when you make an appointment. So, thank you for doing that. That's awesome. Okay, so let's see here. Looks like you have a couple of troubleshooting things, and then you wanted to look at a new laptop. Okay. All right. Let's get some info from you really quick. Some additional info that'll just help the whole process as we go along. I got your first and last name. I got your phone number. Let's get a email for you. Okay. Okay, and mailing address? Okay, and that's street. Okay. And perfect. Perfect. And you've been in here before, correct? Okay, perfect. Okay. So, no, I just make notes as we go along. Helps the process. And then if you ever come back, I can go look at the notes that I made and say, oh, okay, well, I helped her with this. Okay, so how can I help you? What's going on? Okay. Absolutely. No, I can absolutely help you with that. Let me go grab one and I can kind of show you a little bit about it. All right, so let's take a look at it. Okay, so it looks like an iMac keyboard. And what was wrong with it? So this actually comes off like that, and then that's where your batteries are at. So there's just two AA's. So yeah, we'll just replace these. Okay, all right. Put those in here like that, right? And then all you do is you just put this little cap back in, and spin, push in and spin it. Back to normal. Yeah, no, you know, for the design, it's nice because you can't really tell it's there. But now you know. Yeah. Anything else with this? No. Once the batteries are in, it will remember your iMac, so you won't have to sync it or anything. Yeah. Exactly, yeah. No, this is in good shape, so you should be good here. Alright, what's next? So it looks like you found an Apple Watch. Do you want to go over that, or... You're good. Okay, yeah, I can just put this to the side if you're... So are we set on the watch and the band? Alright, cool. So, I'll put this to the side, and then, these will be ready for you when you're done. Alright, so what else can I help you with? An iPhone. Oh, really? No, that's, absolutely, we can do that. yeah, so for the new one, you can absolutely trade in, old ones, and we can give you credit towards the new one. Yeah, did you bring the old one? Oh, you brought... No, that's perfect. Let's do that. All right, yeah, grab them out of your bag, and I'll grab my iPad, and we'll get them entered. All right, so what's the first one that you brought? Really? Okay. This is awesome. I love seeing the old ones. All right, so we have an iPhone 4S in black, and it's a 16 gig. Good. in black. Alright. Oh, and that's a 16 gig as well. Okay. Alright, perfect. Okay, so let's take a look at that. Cool. I love this phone, the 5S. I had this exact same phone in black too. And everything's in here. Everything inside the box. I do the same thing. Yeah. Yep, I love this. I really, really like this phone. Okay, so we got the 5S. Right? And these are all trade-ins, right? Towards the new one. Okay. Alright, so what's the next one? Is that a 16 gig as well? Okay. Alright. And that is in what color? In the white. Okay. Perfect. White and gold. Okay. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Alright, let's take a look at it. Nice. I really liked this box design that they did. With the all white. It was very clean. So what do we got? A plus, okay. 7 plus, and what size? 128 gig, perfect, perfect. That'll be some good money towards the new one. Alright, let's take a look at it. Awesome, okay. You see what I'm saying about, like, let me grab, like, feeling the 4S is so funny compared to, like, the 7 Plus. Nice, okay. I really, I had this before I got the 10. Yeah. I love the black. I love the black, and because this was the matte black, so it wasn't the shiny one that scratched easily. Perfect. You know what? I actually am. I would never say I'm the expert at taking selfies and making everything look good with lighting and everything with Instagram. So, I actually have a colleague that I would love to send you to learn about that. She can give you a little class on how to look good on Instagram and how to take photos with this amazing phone you just got. Yeah, no, Gwen is like basically a supermodel working for Apple. So she's definitely the one to talk to. Okay. All right, so I'm actually going to send you over to Gwen. She's fantastic. And yeah, she'll show you. I'm sure she'll show you how to look amazing. So yeah, I'll send you over to Gwen. And then when you're done, come back and see me. All right.
Hey. So, looks like Maddie sent you in to speak with me, right? Okay, he said that you need help, kind of, with Instagram and how to take selfies and good lighting. Okay, okay. So why don't you tell me a little bit about your Instagram and imagery goals? Yeah, are you looking to create a really beautiful collection of selfies? Are you looking to kind of have a combination of all of it? Do you want help on how to edit photos so that you look amazing, or that so your Instagram feed all flows together really nicely and looks beautiful as a whole? Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, you're obviously great looking already, so that helps. but for sure, I can help you. The number one tip for taking a selfie is natural lighting. In front of a window is the best, especially on days where it's kind of overcast. So it's cloudy, which means you still got light, but it's, not so strong in comparison to actual sunlight, like sun rays coming on you, but it still lights you quite evenly. There's not going to be too many shadows. You can actually keep your eyes open because you're not squinting from the sun. So taking photos on overcast days, even outside, is good, but definitely I find in front of windows is just really good. So that's my number one tip. If you would also like to take photos on days where the lighting isn't good naturally, or maybe if you're taking a photo at nighttime, there are also some tips that I can give you for that as well. Let me just grab a couple of items that I think will help you with that. Just one moment. Selfie. And then it lights you so that you actually have some good lighting, rather than, say, you're taking this photo at nighttime, like we were saying, and you have just the overhead light that's gonna be falling on you and giving you, like, shadows under your eyes, and it's, like, the most unflattering type of lighting that you could probably find. So definitely having some kind of external lighting works really well. So I would definitely recommend investing in a case like this. I mean, it also is pretty heavy duty and will also protect your phone. So it has, like, 2-in-1, and it's cute. Like, this is marble, so they've got all the different trendy kind of things that you might be looking for in terms of design and print. So I'd recommend that. And this, I think I said, was around, like, $50. So I believe we sell it for $49.99, so, and it will actually vary depending on what size phone you have, but, I definitely think it's worth it. If you want to save a little bit, we do sell, these little circle rings, like circle lights, that clip onto your phone. Like, this was your phone, there's just, like, a little clip, and it would clip onto the top, and the circle would go around the camera lens, so you could take a selfie this way, or you can flip it so that it's taking a photo, it's lighting what's in front of you as well, if you want to take a photo of a friend or some what have you. So it's very handy. I definitely recommend it. Like I said, you can get it for a lot cheaper on Amazon. They have those kind of things for like $10. I would just search like ring light for phone, or like ring light clip-on, or anything like that, and the $10 to $15 range is pretty common. When we get ours back in stock, you're more than welcome to come back, but that is $30. So if you are an Amazon fan, like I am for sure, then I would check that out. And that's probably your best option too if you're just kind of starting out with goal photography and Instagram and all of that stuff. Okay, other advice in terms of taking selfies, I think lighting is probably the most important. lashes, and it just makes your eyes pop that little bit more. If you had like a really cool bracelet or any kind of accessories or other details in the photo, you can draw a detail over that. It just makes them pop and stand out just that little bit more. There is also a whitening tool, so if you wanted to whiten your teeth or your eyes, you can do that. I use it mostly for whitening backgrounds and anything like that to make my Instagram feed all kind of uniform and all kind of the same white, rather than having a yellowy white and then a bluey white. They're all kind of cohesive and the same. So those are my tips for that. Another thing is to get the app VS Go Cam, which I'm sure you've heard of. Yeah.
No, sir, I told you we don't sell actual apples here. This is a technology electronic computer store. I know the names. Yeah, no, I get it. Yeah, for sure. All right, see you later. Hey, welcome back. How was it? Awesome, awesome. Yeah, no, Gwen's fantastic. You learn a lot. Yeah, for sure. If anyone is going to look good on Instagram, it's her. So I'm glad I didn't try to teach you all of that, because yeah, for sure. Looks like you grabbed something. What else did you grab? Okay, so you have a Mac, or you have an iMac, right? Because you have the keyboard, and then you want to get a MacBook Pro. Okay, it's gonna be a good day for you. You're coming up, you're getting a new phone and a new MacBook. I've thought about getting an iMac, but the MacBook Pro that I have is maxed out, and so it's really, really fast. And then what I do for a bigger screen, so I have a 13-inch MacBook Pro, and what I do is through the display output, I just go from that to an HDMI, and then I just go to a 50-inch TV at my desk. So I have a faster computer and then a bigger monitor, which the TV is just nice because I do music and video, and so it's nice to be able to edit on a bigger screen, you know. Yeah, and the iMac is amazing, but it only goes up to 27 inches, so yeah, it's kind of my way of having both. And then you can take the MacBook with you anywhere. So actually, yeah, I saw the other day at a coffee shop, I saw someone walk in with the 21.5-inch iMac and just like set it up like it was a laptop. It was awesome. is there anything else that I can help you with? That is a good question. Actually, we just released a new book, a new magazine. I wouldn't call it a magazine, actually. It's like a guide for people who are new to Macs. How long have you had the iMac? Oh, not long. Okay. So here, this is what I would suggest. We just came out with this. And so this is Mac, the beginner guide. Yeah. And so this is every single thing that happens on a Mac. Like picture by, like step by step with pictures. Yeah. No, it's amazing. I highly recommend this if you're trying to learn all the functionalities of a Mac for sure. Did you came from a PC, right? Yeah, I did too. My biggest thing that I would tell people is it's really not that much different. And if you've used an iPhone before, you'll have a huge advantage using a Mac because all the icons are the same. It's just a little bit of a learning curve, learning to use Finder. Like, for instance, like Finder is my computer on PC, you know, that kind of stuff. But, you know, everything is integrated now. It used to be super separated, but you can run Word on a Mac. You know what I mean? You can do both and integrate with both. So, anyway, yeah, definitely get this if you want to know everything. It has every function. So, like, this is about iTunes. This is about the Photos app, which is your photo album. This is the Mail app, Safari. I definitely suggest getting Google Chrome since your email is at Gmail. Definitely download Chrome and use that. Safari's fine, but Chrome is superior to. Okay, you already used it. Perfect. Anyway, definitely get this. I would totally suggest this if you're trying to learn the Mac. Okay, perfect, perfect. All right, so can I help you with anything else? You learned a lot from Gwen. I hope I was instructive. Perfect, perfect. Okay, so we got the watch, we got the phone, we got the MacBook, and the beginner's guide. Is there anything else I can help you with? Yeah, no, the phones will be, we completely wipe them, and then we recycle them. So, yeah, no, there's your data's safe. and you wiped them all anyway, so. But no, we recycle them. That's definitely the most phones I've ever traded in. So, it's awesome. Yeah. All right, well, if that's everything, I can check you out, and then you'll be out of here. All right, thank you so much for coming in. Yeah, again, my name's Maddie. Ask for me when you come in, or Gwen.